De Nijmeegse burgemeester Hubert Bruls was vrijdag in Noorwegen om de titel voor European Green Capital te overhandigen. De titel die in 2018 in Nijmeegse handen was, gaat in 2019 naar Oslo. Bruls hield een toespraak bij de openingsceremonie in het raadhuis. En ook wethouder Harriet Tiemens was aanwezig.
What did it actually mean for you? Did you have any advantages? Did you learn? Did you achieve anything by being the green capital of Europe?
Yeah, obviously one of the main advantages was we had many contacts with other European cities from which we could learn. And being part of a European sustainability family has been the biggest advantage which has come to a city as Nijmegen. You have to imagine Nijmegen is a city of about 180,000 citizens, so quite a moderate European city. And for us it has been this chance of a lifetime to make a step up and to gear up on sustainability goals. Obviously, we have to see in the years to come what the real results will be in having more clear-cut measures, cleaner air, cleaner water, the energy transition. But I'm confident that European Green Capital has been a ticket to speed it up.
So what are you most proud of, what you achieved in Nijmegen?
Well, there are a lot of things, and I could summarize it in we have reached many 10,000 of people, new people, telling about sustainability goals, and we had a lot of professionals, thousands of professionals from all over Europe coming together. I'll give you one example. For us, the clean air depending on the Rhine River is very important. More of the half of the pollution in the air comes from the river, not from the road, from the car traffic. And we have made up an initiative from Rotterdam to Duisburg.
So here you can go swimming, actually.
To address the European Commission to get a more cleaner inland shipping system. And that's one initiative which has come about from being a European Green Capital.
Oh, great, but as I told you, you can go swimming here.
I've heard the story.
So you want to try?
No, it's too cold. Perhaps I'll come back in summer and we'll try it then. No, but it's quite an achievement of which Oslo can be very proud, because seeing it here, it's the first time for me, a large fjord coming out on the sea, and then you can't quite believe that it's possible to swim nowadays. And which open sea it's possible to swim in a harbor in the world? Well, in Oslo it is, so it's quite a compliment for the city.
In your city as well?
No, a river, it's nowadays possible to swim and even find some fish. We had the same problem if you would have come 15 years ago at the Rhine River in Nijmegen and many other places. So, well, everybody would advise against to get even your toe in the water. Nowadays it's possible to swim, but on the other hand, it's very dangerous to go swimming in a river because it flows that hard. So that's a problem we can't solve.